Hello everyone, I, Aarti Bajaj, faculty in MCA department from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on 8085 microprocessors. 8085, it is pronounced as 8085 microprocessor. It is an 8-bit microprocessor designed by the Intel in 1977 using NMOS technology. It has following configuration, like the first one is 8-bit data bus, 16-bit address bus which can address up to 64 KB, a 16-bit program counter, a 16-bit stack counter, and 6 8-bit registers arranged in pairs like BC, DE, HL. It requires the +5V supply to operate at 3.2 MHz single phase clock. It is used in washing machines, microwave ovens, mobile phones, and etc. 8085 microprocessor, the functional units, it has following units, like the first one is accumulator. Accumulator, it is an 8-bit register used to perform the arithmetical, logical, input-output, load-store operations. It is connected to internal data bus and the ALU. ALU, it is arithmetic logic unit. As the name defines, it performs arithmetical and logical operations like addition, subtraction, AND, OR, etc. on the 8-bit data. And the second function is general purpose register. We have 6 general purpose registers in 8085 microprocessor, that is B, C, D, E, H, and L. Each register can hold 8-bit data. These registers can work in pair to hold the 16-bit data, and their pairing combination is like BC, DE, and HL. So, the third function is program counter. Program counter, it is a 16-bit register which is used to store the memory address location to the next instruction to be executed. The microprocessor increments the program whenever an instruction is executed. So the program counter points to the memory address of the next instruction that is going to be executed. The next function is stack pointer. Stack pointer, it is also a 16-bit register. It works like the stacks, which is always incremented or decremented by 2 during the push or the pop operation. The next function is temporary register. Temporary register, it is an 8-bit register which holds the temporary data of arithmetic and logical operation. So the next is flag register. It is also an 8-bit register having the 1-bit flip-flop which holds either the 0 or the 1 depending upon the result stored in the accumulator. There are 5 sets of flip-flop signs, like one is sign S, 0, Z, the auxiliary carry AC, the parity P, and the carry C. These 5 are included in the flag register. The next function is instruction register and the decoder. Both are also the 8-bit register. When an instruction is fetched from the memory, then it is stored in the instruction register. The instruction decoder decodes the information present in the instruction register. Next function is timing and control unit. It provides the timing and the control signal to the microprocessor to perform the operations. Following are the timing control signals which control the external as well as the internal circuits, like the control signals ready, RD for read, WR write, ALU, then status signals S0, S1, input output, DMA signals to hold, HLDA, and the reset signals like reset in, reset out. All these are timing and control unit. The next is interrupt control. As the name suggests, it controls the interrupts during the process. When a microprocessor is executing a main program and whenever an interrupt occurs, the microprocessor shifts the control from the main program to process the incoming request. After the request is completed, the control goes back to the main program. So there are 5 interrupt signals in 8085 processor. The first one is INTR, RST 7.5, RST 6.5, RST 5.5, and the TRAP. These 5 processors work as interrupt signals in 8085 microprocessor. The next function is serial input output control. It controls the serial data communication by using 2 instructions, one is SID, one is SOD. SID, it is serial input data, and SOD, serial output data. These two instructions are using for controlling as a serial input output process. The next function is address buffer and address data buffer. As the content stored in the stack pointer, the program counter is loaded into the address buffer and address data buffer to communicate with the CPU. The memory and the input output chips are connected to these buses. The CPU can exchange the desired data with the memory and input output chips. The next function is address bus and the data bus. The data bus carries the data to be stored. This is bidirectional, whereas address bus carry the location to where it should be stored. It is unidirectional. It is used to transfer the data and address into the input output device. So all these are the functional units of 8085 microprocessor. So after discussing the functional units of 8085, now let's discuss the pin configuration. Pin configuration of 8085 microprocessor. The pins of 8085 microprocessor can be classified into 7 groups. The first group is address bus. Address bus, it pins from A15 to A8. A15 to A8, it carries the most significant 8 bits of memory input output address. The second is data bus. Data bus ranges from AD7 to AD0. It carries the least significant 8-bit address and the data bus. The third is control and status signal. These signals are used to identify the nature of operation. There are 3 control signals and 3 status signals. 3 control signals are read, write, ALE, which is defined as RD, WR and ALE. The first is RD. This signal indicates that the selected input-output or memory device is to be read and is ready for accepting the data available on the data bus. Second is WR. WR for write. This signal indicates the data on the data bus. It is to be written into a selected memory or input-output location. The third is ALE. ALE, it is a positive going pulse generated when a new operation is started by the microprocessor. When the pulse goes high, it indicates the address. When the pulse goes down, it indicates the data. Whereas the 3 status signals are input output M, S0 and S1. The first status signal is input output M. This signal is used to differentiate between the input output and the memory operation. That is, when it is high, it indicates the input output. When it is low, it indicates the memory operation. The second and third is S1 and S0. These signals are used to identify the type of current operation. The third configuration, pin configuration, is power supply. Power supply, as there are 2 power supply signals, the one is VCC, the second is VSS. VCC. VCC indicates the +5 volt power supply, whereas the VSS indicates the ground signal. The fifth configuration is clock signal. We have 3 clock signals, X1, X2, clock out. X1 and X2, these two, in this a crystal is connected as these 2 pins, and it is used to set the frequency of internal clock generator. This frequency is internally divided by 2. The third is clock out. This signal is used as system clock for devices to connect within the microprocessor. The next is interrupts and externally indicated signals. The interrupts are the signals generated by the external devices to request the microprocessor to perform a task. There are 5 interrupt signals. The first one is TRAP, the second one is RST 7.5, the third one is RST 6.5, the fourth is RST 5.5, and the fifth is INTR, which we discuss in the functional unit as well. So we will discuss these interrupts in detail in this section. The first one is INTA. INTA, it is an interrupt acknowledgement signal. The second is RSTN. RSTN, in this signal, it is used to reset the microprocessor by setting the program counter to 0. The third is reset out. Reset out, this signal is used to reset all the connected devices when the microprocessor is reset. Next is ready. This signal indicates that the devices is ready to send or receive the data. If the ready is low, then the CPU has to wait and for ready to go high. The next is hold. This signal indicates that another master is requesting the use of address and the data buses. The next is HLDA. HLDA defines the hold acknowledgement. HLD for hold, A for acknowledge. It indicates that the CPU has received the hold request and it will relinquish the bus in the next clock cycle. HLDA is set to low after the hold signal is removed. The next is serial input output signal. There are two serial signals, SID or SOD, and these signals are used for serial communication. Next is SOD. SOD, serial output data line. The output SOD is set or reset as specified by the same instruction. Next is SID. SID is serial input data line. The data on this line is loaded into the accumulator whenever the RIM instruction is executed. So all these are the pin configuration of 8085 microprocessor. I hope you understand the lecture and it will be beneficial for you. Thank you.